Very good everyone, welcome to IndieSAC. Today I will teach you how to correctly connect a servo drive with any PLC that has a transistor output. Well, let's start. Here we have the servo drive, the servo motor and the PLC. The next thing will be to connect the power. We connect three phases since our servo drive has three phase power for the main circuit and the other single phase terminal block for the PLC. Now it is necessary to connect the L1C and L2C, respectively with the L1 and L2, to activate the control circuit of the input terminal that is the CN1. Then we connect the servo motor, first the encoder cable that goes to CN2, and then the connection terminals U, V, W. Now we will connect the power supply to the PLC, the L and N of the single phase terminal block. Activate the thermal key. We can see that the PLC turned on and the servo drive too. In the PLC we will use the outputs to be able to control the servo motor, its speed and position. For this we need the 24 volt power supply of the PLC. We use the 24V+ and COM. Now we see that the PLC has various COM, such as COM 0, COM 1, COM 2. That means that it is PNP output, that is, its output is a negative signal. Well, now that we know that, the truth is that we will control a single servo drive, we need to activate the Y0 output, which will be the one that sends a pulse signal of up to 200 kHz speed, and also the Y1 to change the rotation. To activate its outputs we first need the COM 0, and we join it with the COM. Well, now we will use the output Y0 and Y1. Now in the servo drive in the CN1 terminal to make the connections to the PLC. We will visualize your manual. Well, in my case, I am using the servo drive US200 of the star power drive. Well, we go to your diagram. We look for the driver's local control, this diagram to control his position and speed. Well, most of all servo drives, whether from the best known brands such as Yaskawa or Delta among others, always have their local or position diagram, so that the PLC can control it. So we look closely at the power supply. We have that terminal 35 is 24 volts. And terminal 6 is the activation in the on state of the servo drive, which needs a negative to activate. Well, we just need to feed it. Now we look for the servo drive control. Well, here we have it, it's called position control. We have two options to control it with 5 volts or 24 volts. In this case we will use 24 volts directly without resistors, since in the 24 volt diagram internally it has a 3K resistor that protects it. For this we have terminal 31, it is a positive pulse 1, it is a negative pulse 2, it is a positive send 4, it is a a negative sense. In case of using 5 volt, place your resistance. Also, both have the benefit of supporting a maximum of 200 kHz, so it's perfect for the PLC. Most servo drives usually have both options. Let's continue with the connections. Now we join all the positive terminals 35, 31, and 2, which are 24 volt positive pulse and positive sense respectively. We connect it to the 24 volts of the PLC. Now terminal 6, we connect it to the COM. We can see that the servo changed its status from ready to run. Now we connect terminal 1 to Y0. And terminal 4 to Y1. Well, in case your PLC was NPN, that is, output positive, we join all the negatives to the negative of the PLC, and the positives to each output. Well, now we turn on the run state of the PLC with the programming already done. Well, we tested the servomotor in speed mode. As you can see, the PLC is on, only the Y0 output is turning to the right. We increase its speed. Stop. Now we are turning to the left at high speed. We lower its speed. We see that the PLC is on outputs Y0 and Y1. Stop. Now the position mode with 10 turns to the right at high speed. Now 5 turns to the right at low speed. Now 5 turns to the left at low speed. Now 10 turns to the left at high speed. Finally 90 degrees to the right, 180 degrees to the right, return to its starting position. Well, I hope you like the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give your like if you like the video. Thanks, bye.